家好，我是 Alexa。
Good evening, my name is Alexa。
目前就读于中心大学三年级文系。
I'm a junior in National Zhongxin University, and my major is Foreign Languages and Literatures.
虽然我是日间部的学生，但我是个夜猫子。
I have classes in the day, but I'm a night owl.
白天懒洋洋，晚上却特别有精神。
I feel sleepy at daytime, but feel energetic at night.
你们也有这样的困扰吗？我想这应该是大学生的通病吧。
Do you have the same problem just like I do? I guess this might be a common problem for college students.
所以呢，我选在夜晚跟大家介绍这个吸引了很多人慕名前来的景点——中心湖。
Therefore, that's why I choose to give a tour at night. 中心湖 attracts a lot of people.
在2013年，有一部爱情国片叫《爱情无权顺》。
In 2013,A Taiwanese movie named Campus Confidential was filmed here.
电影里的中心湖被改名为菊湖。
In this romantic movie, Zhongxin Lake was renamed Ji Lake.
菊湖里有一个浪漫又有趣的传说。
There is a romantic and interesting stories of Ji Lake.
在月圆之夜，如果有男女学生在湖水干涸时相遇，两人将注定厮守终身。
It goes that if a man and woman met with each other at a dry lake in the full moonlight, they would fall in love with each other and stay together forever.
单身的同学有没有很心动吗？
Does it sound exciting to those of you who are single?
借由这部电影，也使中心湖的美被更多人发现。
Zhongxin Lake was known to more people because of this movie.
白天的中心湖有茂盛的植物，还有许多小动物。
During the daytime, you could see Zhongxin Lake surrounded with plants, trees, and a lot of cute animals.
鲜丽充沛的鹅群最吸引人。
The energetic geese are the most fun to watch.
但是比起白天，夜晚的中心湖已毫不逊色。
However, in contrast to the scene of the daytime, the night scene is more appealing.
灯光闪烁在湖面，迷蒙的夜色替中心湖增添了浪漫的氛围。
The light twinkles above the lake, and the misty night creates a romantic ambience around the lake.
各位夜猫子们，快动身到中心湖享受夜色吧。
The night owls have gathered here to enjoy the beauty of the Zhongxin Lake.
也许真的会遇见你未来的另一半哦。
Maybe you will meet your soulmate in the future.
各位同学怎么样？我觉得在刚刚我们看到的这样子的一个来来回回的这样的一个发表，我反而觉得译者的表现比讲者好，因为感觉上，因为讲者你有看稿嘛，那么反而是译者是很自然，然后。反应很快，反正是没有看稿。那有的时候的确在我们在业界哦做翻译的时候，会有遇到这样的情形，就是讲者很紧张，讲者从头到尾都看稿，或者是说他都没有抬起头来。那反倒是译者是没有稿，反正译者你今天没有稿，你就只好看着底下的观众，对不对？所以其实我们在业界时，有时候遇到这种情形，就是说，其实译者反而是没有稿，而且是一直在看观众的嘛，因为你没有稿，你也不能干嘛，就只好。看一下底下观众的反应。那么刚刚其实，心怡，其实我觉得你的表现其实不错，但是有点可惜的是，你可能花太多时间在看这个稿，那反而是说译者的表现反而比较自然，因为你没有稿，就是看着底下的观众。我觉得哲书他的，我觉得你的声音是很自然，我觉得挺好的。你的翻译也很忠实，很完整。我觉得有一件事情很有趣，我不知道大家有没有注意到，就是你在拿麦克风那个手其实是在抖的。那刚刚其实黄心有一点点紧张，好像有一点点，对不对？那其实任何人在做翻译，因为翻译的本质，口译的本质是你有观众才翻嘛，所以其实都是会紧张。今天会紧张，不管你观众是十个、一百个，有时候我们甚至做一些口译场合，观众是上千人来记的，那一定都是，不论是怎么样会紧张，就是会紧张。但是呢，哲书你很好玩哦，你刚刚你的手在抖，我们其实都会稍微看得到，因为我们坐得比较近一点。但是你的声音是听不出来的，我觉得这个是你的优势，而且你也有保持一些 eye contact， 我觉得这都是挺好的。 觉得还可以继续加油。好，那我们请杰森老师帮我们讲一下。
A couple things I noticed. Your partner didn't make it extremely easy for you. She used some vocabulary that was a little bit more difficult, like ambiance and things like that, and you adapted to that well. It also seemed like, I don't know if it's intentional or not, but it seemed like you're actually adapting to what she said, like it wasn't memorized or planned out, but that you're really just taking it as it comes. It seems that way. Maybe you were prepared, I don't know, but it's good that it seems that way. Also, you start out a little bit fast, and you had to slow down a little bit, and once you slowed down, it seemed a lot smoother, a lot more natural. My only, I would say, mark against you is that you're having a little bit of trouble with words like in, at, and from, and for. Like sometimes you would say, instead of like at the lake, you'd say in the lake. You don't necessarily want to be in the lake, maybe. I don't know about anybody else, but I've heard that it's not a good place to go swimming. And just some words like that, like before you're talking about the place, describing whether you're in, at, before, from, things like that. But otherwise, very good.
Okay.